Coming up, we take a look at updates to Conditional Access, part of Microsoft's Enterprise Mobility and Security solution that allows you to apply access controls to company data. We're going to explore the new Unified Azure Administration Portal, the expansion of Conditional Access controls that specify the app and data access based on the users and committed locations and compliant devices. And then we're going to have a look at risk-based conditional access controls that incorporate machine learning to continuously safeguard access to your apps and data in real time. So today I'm joined by Alex Simons, a regular on the show from the Enterprise Mobility and Security team. Alex, welcome to the show.
Hey Simon, nice to be back.
So Alex, we've covered conditional access in a couple of previous shows, and I know that it's a set of policy rules that define the circumstances under which users get access to corporate data. But before we go into some of the changes that I know that we've made in the product, can you tell us like a little bit more about conditional access, just a level set for folks?
Yeah, sure, Simon. Look, so in the old days, everybody had, you know, like a firewall and a directory and some PCs and servers, but it was all kind of on-premise, and that gave you control over things. You knew what was going on. You didn't have to worry about security very much. You didn't have to worry about, were people doing the right things, right? But as the internet comes along, right, and all of a sudden there are things like Salesforce.com and Concur maybe that people want to use, and as employees are bringing lots of devices like their iPhones and their, you know, Android devices to work and want to get those to get work done on, all of a sudden IT had a big challenge, right? And initially, you know, you could just hook up maybe one app, or you could give somebody a VPN on their device so they could get back to your corporate network. And that kind of worked in 2009, right? But as you get to more and more of your corporate IT estate being in the cloud in lots of different services, and as your employees want to use more and more devices, and as customers and partners want to connect with you, it all just falls apart. You can't use your firewall and your on-premise directory to manage that anymore, right? So really what you need is you need a cloud control plane that lets you coordinate between all those different resources and people and devices in a way that is compliant and secure. And that's what conditional access is in the enterprise mobility suite. It lets you do things like dictate corporate policy on, hey, where, which users can get to which things, which devices do they have to be on, where can they come from, what kind of authentication strength do they have, and then even what locations are they in? Is the app a risky app or a not risky app in terms of the business impact? And then finally, even a risk score from our machine learning system on, does this really look like it's the user who they say they are or not? And all of those can work together in a conditional access system to make you secure and compliant.
That's great. That's a really good level set. How have we actually been improving conditional access though?
Well, the biggest change in conditional access recently has been bringing all of those capabilities together in one administrative portal, right? So now in the new Azure portal, you can go in and you can see all of your conditional access policies across Azure Active Directory and Intune in one place.
Cool.
The second big improvement has been adding the ability to have multiple policies per application and to share policies across applications, as well as for your whole tenant. And then finally, we've also brought risk scores in. So now you can have conditional access policies that include the risk score as well as all of those other factors.
So Alex, these sound like great features. Can you show us them in action?
Yeah, so let's take a look at a demo like I was an employee at the company.
Okay,
so here I am in the My Apps portal for Azure Active Directory, and you can see all the apps that have been assigned to me. Each of these have different policies depending on the app sensitivity that my admins created for us. Okay, so let's take an easy one, like Box. You know, the security level on that, they're not too worried about. I can just click and get immediately single signed into Box, no problem, right? But a more sensitive app like Salesforce, you know, it has all our customer records and stuff. Mm-hmm. I probably want to do a two-factor authentication for that, right? Yeah. So let me get out my phone here, and then we'll go ahead and I'm going to click on Salesforce, and you'll see how it's going to force me to do a second-factor authentication before I'm able to log in. So on my phone, I'm going to get a call, and this then adds a whole new level of security to the login. So now we really know it's me before I can get into Salesforce.com, and you'll see, look, there, my authentication completed. Pretty cool.
Excellent. Okay.
Right. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at a really sensitive app. Right. This is one which maybe has some like financial data or something that I can't access if I'm not on the corporate network. Right. So here we are in the studio. Obviously, I'm not on the corporate network. Let's go ahead and click on this one, and you'll see that as we try to log into this app, it tells me, oh, I just can't get there from here. There's nothing I can do about that.
That's pretty cool.
And I even have details here that show me the IP address that I came from so that if I need to call help desk or something, it's easy for them to figure out what's going on.
What about if you're coming from a device that we know nothing about?
Yeah, so you know, some things are pretty sensitive and you might not want people to be able to download documents or things like that. So let's take a look at this SharePoint site. On this SharePoint site, when I try to log in, this device isn't registered yet and managed by my MDM. So the SharePoint, when I log in, comes up and tells me, hey, I can't get there, but it gives me instructions on how to get my device managed. And all I have to do is click on that. And here you can see I'm in the experience to get my device managed by my company so I can get access.
That's pretty cool. And that's going to take you through the Intune enrollment process. So
yes, exactly.
Really nice. Yeah. So Alex, you also mentioned risky logons. What happens in those circumstances?
Well, so Simon, our machine learning system in identity protection is watching every single logon for suspicious activity. Mm-hmm. And so if I try to log in something that looks risky, it's going to block me because it, you know, most likely I'm a hacker. So let's take a look here. I'm going to try to log into that same account using a Tor browser.
Okay.
Right? And a Tor browser is just an example of the kind of thing maybe a hacker might do. So if I try to log into my Office account using that Tor browser, let me just get my password here. You'll see what's going to happen is in real time, my login is scored and it's high risk because it's coming from an anonymous IP address. And so I've been blocked and I can't get in here.
That's a pretty awesome and robust set of controls that you've been able to build directly into the product.
Yeah, it really lets you create corporate policy for both compliance and security reasons, right? That keeps your data secure, but also lets the board of directors sleep at night.
So how do we get this all working from an IT point of view?
Yeah, so Simon, we've been talking about how this has all been brought together in the new Azure portal. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Here I am in my Azure AD Blade, but we're going to take a look at the conditional access policies. So the first thing I want you to see here is here's all my conditional access policies, and you can see that I have multiple different policies, some of them based on, for instance, like the high business impact and medium business impact applications. But I can also have multiple policies per application. So you can see here, this is a Salesforce policy about requiring multi-factor authentication. This down here is a Salesforce policy that says I can't get to it from an Android device. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at the require MFA policy for Salesforce and how that works. So here you can see is my policy. I can pick which set of users and groups it applies to. For instance, I could pick all users or select users and groups. In this case, the sales group. I can also, if I want, exclude some people from it. So here, the administrators have been excluded, so they can always get in to get work done. Mm-hmm. I can choose which applications this policy applies to. So you can see here, in this case, obviously, it's a Salesforce policy. But I could use this for other apps as well if I want to. I can just add a new one, or I can make it apply to all my applications. That's been really popular with customers. Mm-hmm. And then I can select the conditions under which this applies. So let me show you this. This is probably the coolest part, right? So first, I can, like we were talking about, I can have my sign-in risk, right? So let's go ahead and turn on some sign-in risk here. And so now when the identity protection system sees that this is a higher medium risk login, I want it to block those. So I'm going to make it apply to those higher medium risk logins. I want to also make it so that people have to be using a managed device. Like it's, you can't just use this on your home PC,
yeah.
Right? That's just too risky. So I'm going to configure this so that all of my platforms, Android, iOS, Windows Phone, and Windows, all have to be in a managed and compliant state. I can pick the locations that people can get to it from. For instance, I could set up a whole range of IP addresses that represent my corporate network, so you can only get to it for that. But given it's a sales app, I want people to be able to use it wherever they are. And then finally, I can pick which kinds of applications even can access the service. So in this case, you can see here, I've set it up so that only people using a browser can get to it so they can't download the data and take off with it. Right, so that's a pretty cool set of conditional access policies. And now let's go ahead and take a look at the way that I can control whether they get access or not.
Yeah.
Right? So those are all the things that essentially say, should this policy be applied now? Mm-hmm. Right? And then now here I can say, okay, look, I want to either block access, so if the risk score was super high, block access, or I want to allow access, but I want to require some things, right? So in this case, we're requiring multi-factor authentication, but I'm going to update this to also require that their devices be compliant. And then one of the really cool things is down here, you can decide how restrictive is this? Am I going to require them to do an MFA and have a compliant device, or is either one okay?
So we've built some really granular controls and compliance policy.
Yeah. I mean, essentially, you can now take all of those different pieces of context we were talking about, the user and their auth strength and their device, and make sure that you've got a policy that meets your corporate security and compliance requirements.
And what level of reporting is there around this?
You can see all kinds of stuff. So for instance, every time you want to look and see, okay, what were users doing? Was there anything that seemed risky? You can come in and check out all your users. So here, let's take a look at Jennifer Davis. You'll see that Jennifer has 10 high-risk events that have been flagged by the machine learning system. And I wonder what the heck is going on. And you can see all kinds of stuff happening here. She signed in from an anonymous IP address. She seems to have tried to sign in from a place that was too far for her to go to. She's coming from an infected device and from locations where no one in our work ever goes. Most likely, Jennifer's account has been hacked, right? Maybe she was phished or something like that. And there's someone trying to log in as her. So I'm going to go ahead and require her to reset her password. So the next time she comes in, she'll have to pick a new password and complete an MFA so that we can reclaim her account and get it out of the hands of hackers.
So Alex, it's fantastic to see that we've got this granularity of controls available across the whole of enterprise mobility and security and in a single UI. What else are we investing in?
Well, so Simon, you can really see how we're bringing all of the capabilities of the enterprise mobility and security suite together in one control plane, right? And so what you'll see is more and more of this kind of work where we bring the controls of Intune, the controls of Azure AD, and all the rest of the enterprise mobility suite into one administrative experience and integrate all those capabilities together.
What are the next steps that people should take?
Well, Simon, all of this is working today and available, right? So anyone who wants to can just go to the Azure portal and try it out. Or if you want to learn more, just click on the link below.
Alex, thanks a lot for coming on the show. You can also keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the very latest tech updates. We'll see you soon.